Becky! Oh. Are you okay?
Well, if it's okay for my husband to give the Roscoes a secret check for 10 grand, yeah, then I'm fine. I'm absolutely okay.
Frankie, I'm sure it's just a present for the vow renewal. Can you call?
Oh, from Jack McScrew, she was but joking. I've seen their cozy little chats.
Well, what does she say about it?
You know what? That's one way of finding out.
You were found.
Oh, Sandy. What a nice surprise.
Is it?
I didn't think they'd let you have breaks in this job. You always seem to be so busy. Pay all right, does it?
Why are you here, Frankie?
A prostate.
Oh, I knew you had a pass before Jack, but...
I'm here for Jack.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why do you care so much?
Jack and I go way back. You know that.
Yeah, well, his prostate's fine, thank you very much. He's got the reproductive glands of a 20-year-old boy. You know, just doing a bit of research. Can't be too careful, can you?
Okay. Well, I've got to go.
Why did Jack give you luck 10,000?
I don't know what you're going on about. And look, this is my place of work. You need to go.
You know, I pity your poor patient, Sandy Roscoe. I mean, what hope have they got with a lying cow like you for a counsellor?
Oi, watch your mouth.
No, I'm not going to let you shut me up. And I'm not going to let you keep in the dark either. Not anymore.
Sandy, love. What can I get you?
Maybe a muzzle for that wife of yours?
Excuse me?
Look, I can take her handing me round here, but now she's coming to where I work.
I just wanted to find out the truth.
Oh, not that damn cheque again.
10 grand, Jack. 10 grand. You know, we can't afford that kind of money, let alone you lending it to a dodgy family.
The only dodgy one round here, love, is you.
Oh, do you know what? Just do one, you trollop.
Frankie! I'm so sorry, Sandy. Joe just mentioned that the garage was struggling. And I know how tough it is running a family business these days. It's a short-term loan till they get back on their feet again. Now, Frankie, please, stop embarrassing yourself. Why wouldn't you...
Oh, my God, have you heard the news about Mr. Blake? Apparently, he's been arrested for killing his psycho wife.
Excuse me? That psycho happened to be my mother. And this day has been difficult enough without your stupid rumours.
Ignore them, love. Come and sit by me. You know what you're going through. I've been there, but I am there. Losing your mum is the worst. The only person who's always there for you, you can go to when you're struggling. They'll give you whatever you need, no questions asked.
Yeah, well, my mum was never that person. My dad is.
Well, it's a special event, so we're going to need twice a usual order of champagne, please.
Ruben, how old do you reckon Joe Roscoe is? Late 20s, early 30s?
Yeah, I guess so.
And Jack and Sandy go back a long time.
And?
Well, it's like the girls were saying downstairs. Who would you go to for help if you were really struggling? You know, for 10 grand's worth of help, no questions asked, eh?
Frankie, you've totally lost me.
That's why Joe Roscoe came to see Jack. He's Jack's son.
You know, I have to...